mixing food production with a tourism experience. I've come to visit Maurice Gilbert at the Ballyhoura Apple Farm.
Hello, Mary.
How are you?
Welcome to Kilfinan.
Thank you very much. And Ballyhoura Apple Farm.
Ballyhoura Apple Farm, yeah. We're here for the last couple of years. We moved our orchard a few years ago from Churchtown to Kilfinan due to a number of reasons. Mm-hmm. But we were lucky enough then to acquire this premises, which was an old Shannon development premises.
It's lovely because I see your logo is Apple Farm, like the old days, a taste of bygone days.
A taste of bygone days,
and
exactly.
There is a kind of a nostalgic feel to this whole place, isn't there?
There is, and I think that is what we tried to achieve, and I suppose I pulled on a little bit of the experience I had at carpentry in a former life.
Really?
Because I was involved in construction until 2009 when the collapse came in the building industry. And
is that when you decided to go into the apple farming?
Well, yes, I looked around at what assets we had, and we had an orchard to work with. And I started doing juice.
Mm-hmm.
We started with plain juice. And then when the market for that was dying away towards the end of the year, we came up with a mulled apple juice. We took that to Glasnevin here and got silver for best new prize.
I see you've got loads of prizes around the place.
We have quite a lot. Mm-hmm.
And this is very popular nowadays, isn't it? We're all supposed to be having apple cider vinegar, aren't we?
The cider vinegar. Well, I suppose that... And this is our basic apple cider product. Completely natural. A huge amount of help.
And you also have your eye on the fact that this is, I suppose, now part of the Munster Vales, but very touristy because you have a kind of a visitor experience.
We have, because we'll say on our own premises, we bring people in, and we've brought several coach loads of culinary arts students in particular, and we tell them our story, how we got going and what we do here, the development of our various products. But we also have the likes of the hostel down the road, which is a brilliant experience for anybody coming to town. We have shooting out the road at the clay pigeon shoot. We've horse riding, and of course the mountain bike trail is one of the big things around here.
And it's an area of archaeological interest as well, isn't it?
It is, because right adjacent to our property, if you look just out the door there, Mary, you'll see the moat, which is, in my opinion, 4,000 to 5,000 years old. And there are huge archaeological remains around that.
That'll be interesting.
It will. We're not on a beaten track, so we have to have it a destination. Mm-hmm. And that was our thinking when we were here. You know, that we would be able to cater for people, we would be able to get them in, and give them the experience of the apple farm.
I hear a few little whispers over the partition here. You've got people in.
We have, Mary. And we're going to give them a little tasting if you'd like to join us.
I would, I really would. Come on, I believe you have them starved in case their taste buds would be affected. Is that it?
Exactly.
Are you
like to sit here, Mary?
I will.
Follow the sun, which way the wind blows, when this day is done.
And so we come to the end of this evening's programme. I hope you've enjoyed our journey around the Munster Vales. There's a lovely little brochure here that I picked up, and it gives you all of the options that are on offer. There's the mountains, there's the caves, there's the river, there's the apples, there's beautiful little villages. A really nice addition, I think, to the tourism options for this country. And I will be putting it on the list of jaunts for this summer. But seeing as we're finishing off in the Ballyhoura Apple Farm, sure, you'd have to have a little glass in your hand. Apple juice, slide to one. On Fridays Nationwide,